Welcome back to CityLine. With me, I have someone who, well, I haven't seen since pre-COVID on the white comfy couch in our TV Tacoma studios. I'm talking about somebody who spreads a lot of music and a lot of joy in our community with himself and also his world orchestra. So please join me in welcoming Kareem Candy, the executive director of the Kareem Candy World Orchestra. Hello, my friend, how are you?
Hi, Amanda. I'm doing well. Thank you so much for having me. It's a pleasure to be here in these crazy times and situations. So I'm so happy to be here to talk with you guys today and glad that everybody's doing well, knock on wood, so far.
It is great to see you as well. And you are in your studio. So I have to say, what a wonderful backdrop that you have in terms of us having this conversation today. So Kareem, when we think about Tacoma Creates, which is such a wonderful presence that we have here in our city, how does it support the arts in Tacoma?
Well, it supports in several ways. Number one, it helps ensure that arts are accessible and available to everybody throughout the city. In the past, certain things might have had fees attached to them or maybe were in areas where not everybody could reach. But what Tacoma Creates tries to do is to make sure that everybody can get to and access arts one way or another, no matter where they are. And it also represents, tries to represent as much as it can, as much heritage and culture, and to be as inclusive as it can to make sure that everybody is represented as well. So they're doing quite a good job, and we're very fortunate to have it throughout the city.
Oh, absolutely. Because as you and I both know, being artists, and it's written across our hearts, art is for everyone. So based on that belief, what programming does the Kareem Candy World Orchestra present with that Tacoma Creates sponsorship?
Sure. Well, prior to sheltering in place, one of our big goals is to make sure that most of the programming that we do throughout the year is free and accessible to everybody. So, you know, that means if you want to come enjoy something, there's not a ticket price attached to that, whether we're doing a masterclass or an interview or a workshop. And also prior to sheltering in place, we were doing a lot of programs in the schools through the what's known as the ELO programs, Extra Learning Opportunities. And so we were working with, over the course of our starting to work with Tacoma Creates, six different schools we managed to work with before things started closing down. So, but we would go into schools after school let out, and we would work with students providing free programming with jazz education and help them learn with regular music that they're working on in band or improvisation and things of that nature. So beyond that, we have our weekly jazz workshop, which it helps, it's the class that we're still offering right now, which that would help with scholarships for students that weren't able to afford tuition for that, or for most of the concerts that we actually present throughout the year, it's 100% free for people to enjoy. So really helps out a lot in many ways.
So given the current changes, Kareem, with COVID-19, what programming is being offered at this point?
Sure. So one of the main things that we've been able to do is almost all of our programming, for the most part, we've been able to adapt and move online. So for example, we're still doing our weekly jazz workshop, which currently is a hybrid class. So some people come in person and some people participate online, and that we break into small groups and we work on improvising and playing as a group and working on learning material and learning how to improvise and spontaneously compose, if you will. So that's still going strong. We've also been maintaining our, we have a weekly performance series that we do where we are bringing in different artists and performing with them for an hour concert every single week. And along with that, we're composing brand new music every single week. So not only are we just like, we're not playing a rehashed music from the past, we're writing brand new compositions every single week, an hour's worth of music, and then performing it. And then we're also doing an interview series where we have different artists from around the world and around the Pacific Northwest come and talk about their lives and their history and performing and what's beneficial for them as musicians and improvisers and composers. And then we're also working on another international exchange. We had to cancel our tour of France this last fall, but we are hoping to be able to redo that in the spring, and so we'll be doing that as well. And there's a lot of stuff coming up, but basically what I'm trying to get across here is all of our programming, for the most part, has been adapted and moved online, and we're doing just as much as we were before, if not more.
That is an incredible amount of work and dedication, because as you and I both know, just to say we have moved things online is such a simple sentence, but it doesn't belie the amount of work that is involved. So I want to break down the interview masterclass series that you offer. Tell us what it is and who is it designed for?
Well, it's designed for everybody. And not only are we live streaming these in real time, but then we're posting the videos up afterwards onto our YouTube page so that people can go back and watch it as much as they want. Because if you're like me, you might watch something and then you watch it a second time and catch something that you missed. So it's for everybody and it's accessible. It's made for all ages, whatever stage of enjoyment, whether you're a musician or not a musician or just an enthusiast or just want to learn more about music. I mean, that's what it's there for. But some of the artists that we're interviewing, they all are professional, you know, artists, composers, performers, educators in their fields, or all three combined. And we, for example, we've done several interviews with a great trombonist by the name of Julian Priester, who was one of my professors at Cornish College of the Arts in Seattle. And his career has spanned working with some of the jazz greats. He was in the bands of Max Roach and performed with Freddie Hubbard, Duke Ellington, Herbie Hancock. You know, firsthand connections with these people that are masters of American music and African American music, I should say. And so hearing him talk about his experiences growing up and learning how to play and being on these famous albums and working with these bands, I mean, that's invaluable information that is now being cataloged saved so that we can watch it and enjoy those things indefinitely.
You know, what you have just said reminds me of some of my experiences when I've sat at Jazz Bones or Jazz Alley and got to talk last year with Herb Albert and ask him questions from the balcony. I was screaming. It is such an impact to be able to talk to musicians, or for you and I, those jazz greats that inspire us, to hear about how they have similar thoughts that you and I have, but they also have very unique ways of looking at music. So speaking of that, you've got some performance series that is being presented by the Korean Candy World Orchestra. Tell us what we can look forward to.
Well, let's see. Coming up this coming Sunday, we've got the marvelous David Marriott will be joining us. He is a composer, arranger, and trombonist from the Seattle area. He lived in New York for quite some time, and he's a massive wealth of knowledge. He's one of the strongest arrangers here in the Pacific Northwest, but he's played with some of the jazz greats as well, and comes from a musical family, so that'll be great. We're in the works with doing another program with Julian. Priester will be joining us next month for another talk, as well as a great pianist and educator, Carolyn Gray, is coming up. We're going to be doing some more stuff down the road with a great piano player by the name of George Colligan, the great Brazilian composer, Jovino Santos Neto. So we've got a lot all over the map, like different cultures and styles of music within the jazz spectrum are going to be represented. And not only are these artists coming in to talk and do interviews and perform, but they're also composing music for these things. So, I mean, that's kind of the cool thing about this, because part of Tacoma Creates is the generation of new artwork. So we're kind of covering all of the bases. So we're doing the historical cataloging, we're talking about things that are applicable to students and also non-musicians, but also we're generating new artwork, an entire hour of music every single week.
I love that. So in my family, people laugh at me because I can make a song out of anything. I don't know where that came from, but I can make jingles out of nothing. So if we have someone who is like me, who is watching, or a parent that has a child, how could they get involved in that composer workshop, or would that fit perhaps their interest?
Sure. Well, the composer workshop and the performance is that's not necessarily open to the public. But what I mean by it is, because people can actually all of these videos that we're doing, they're live streamed and people can interact in real time. They can type in comments and ask questions. And the interview series in particular, like, we open up the last 15 minutes of each one of the interviews for people to add questions so that we can answer them. And if we can't answer them in real time on the live stream, then we can go back in and go to the comment feed afterwards and then answer the questions that way. So the performance and the composer workshop isn't necessarily open for like a class structure like our weekly workshop would be. So if people did want to learn how to compose and actually get a lot of like hands-on help, that would be more for the weekly jazz workshop that we offer. And we're doing two of those every single week, that's open to all ages and abilities. So that would be certainly a place where people could come to and ask and get help.
Oh, I love that. And I am just assuming, because knowing how efficient you are, all of that information on that webpage below that beautiful face is where we can find out more information to tune in to all these great programs.
Yes, most definitely. I mean, it has information about the class. There's not a whole lot of information about the live streams other than a good way to get information. I send out an email every single week about what's going on. So if people wanted to get information about classes and workshops and interviews and that kind of stuff, the best way would be to subscribe to the email list, and it's sent out usually every Monday or Tuesday. But in terms of information for the classes and things that we're doing, the website is a great resource. And it also has, I would say, if anybody has any questions, they can always call or email me directly, and I'd be more than happy to let them know what's going on and how they can get involved.
You have some great support with Tacoma Creates, and you are also, at least in my heart, a hometown favorite. That aside, I feel like I'm your mother because you can do no wrong. How can our audience and how can people support the Kareem Candy World Orchestra in terms of what you're doing in this community?
Well, there's lots of different ways. I mean, one, just if students are interested in learning how to do this, sign up for a class. And if they're nervous about, well, I can't pay for it, don't worry about it. We can make sure that it's open to everybody and anybody can participate in our classes. There is tuition involved, but if people can't afford it, doesn't matter. We'll make it work one way or the other, period. That's one of our main focuses, is making sure that anybody can participate. If people want to volunteer to help with our efforts, the best way is just get in touch with me, because that changes on like a day-to-day basis depending on what we're doing. But right now it's kind of like me doing everything. I've got a great board, but I kind of run everything, so it's a lot of work and I could use help. If people want to support us monetarily, they can make a donation on our website or via PayPal or Venmo. And usually all of that stuff is on the broadcast that we send out about how they can do that. And the easiest way, I mean, if people want to find an easy way to do it, they just watch the videos, just enjoy it and tell people about it, because it's funded by legislation that was voted by the citizens of Tacoma. And it's for the citizens of Tacoma. So the best way to support it, another really great way, is just to utilize it. And so, like I said, the live streams, watching the live streams, or, you know, watching the videos on YouTube after the fact and taking part in it.
Kareem, I cannot say thank you enough for what you give to our community and beyond our community. You are truly an artist that shares your gift. And you also let us just sit and bask in the glow of your gift. So thank you for bridging that full 180 of performing, but also teaching, and then bringing it back home again. I'm going to say goodbye to our City Line family, and then you are going to play us out. You are one of the first musicians to ever play us out of my kitchen. So I'm going to say goodbye, and then I'm going to switch it back to you, but I want to say thank you again so much.
Thank you for having me. It's been a pleasure, and I hope everyone is staying safe and happy and healthy out there. And I'm going to play a song by the great Harold Arlen that most people should know, and it's from The Wizard of Oz, entitled Somewhere Over the Rainbow.
Okay, you get yourself ready and then reintroduce that. And I'm going to say, as always, that wraps up another great segment of City Line. Zooming from my kitchen, it is always a pleasure and a privilege to be with you. We've given you some great things to think about in this past hour. And above all, please continue to wear your mask, wash your hands, keep your gatherings small, and keep yourself socially distant, but not emotionally distant. Check in with those loved ones, your family and friends, because we're all in this together and we can get through this together. And when you come back, as always, I'll be waiting for you right here on City Line. Kareem, tell us what you're gonna play one more time.
Sure thing. This is Somewhere Over the Rainbow by the great composer Harold Arlen.